Hello, peoples, and welcome back to Breezy's Craft.
Kids Craft.
Kids Crafts. And today we'll be learning how to make
a giant slurm.
No, not a giant. A cardboard box. No, we're not.
A slurm trap.
No. A bed for your stuffed animal and a cardboard box.
Ah.
You'll need a cardboard box, markers, a stuffed animal, a pillow, and something that you can use as a blanket. So, first of all, you need to get your cardboard box. Which is a good thing that I have one right here. And then you need to get some markers. I have some right here. And then you need to get your stuffed animal, your pillow, and your phone.
Can you use fabric, Crazy?
You can use a scrap of fabric. You can use whatever you want, but I decided to use foam.
What about paper?
Yeah, you can use paper. And so what you'll need is
toilet paper.
Daddy, you can use whatever you want. And so what I did with my foam is I did a little design on it. So I basically used the markers and just kind of scribbled on it.
That doesn't look like scribbles, that looks like a heart.
Yeah, there's little hearts and stuff. I did a pattern on mine. You can do whatever you want for the blanket, but then, so that's your blanket. Now you need to choose your stuffed animal. I chose a little bunny. And a pillow, which may or may not be ripped.
It looks like it is for sure, though.
I'm going to go get another pillow.
What?
I'm just kidding, though. Okay, so next up, you need to use your cardboard box and decorate it. So I'm going to do a sun and a sky. You can see I'm going to turn it around. You can see this. Let's hope you can see this. You might want to zoom in the camera. So you can basically do whatever you want on your cardboard box. I'm going to do kind of like stuff. That's okay. And so basically you just do pretty much whatever you want. You can copy what I'm doing, but I don't care. I don't even know you, so he does care. So you basically just do a little, just anything you want on your box. And then for the inside, if you want to decorate the inside as well, you can, but that I don't want to, so I'm not going to. You can pause the video to do any steps but whatsoever. So, and then what you're going to do is assemble. Next, you need to assemble your pieces. So what you're going to do is take your pillow, which may or may not be ripped.
For sure is.
And so what you're going to do is you're going to put it inside of the cardboard box at the very end, right there. And then you're going to put your stuffed animal's head.
Wait, just its head?
No, its entire. on its head on the pillow, like that. And then you can put the blanket on the pillow, whatever you want on it, if you can see this. I have such a small cardboard box that I can't really fit the entire blanket there. I have to turn it like
that. You can tuck it in. That blanket's tucked in.
You can make multiple blankets as well. So, I'm going to do another blanket just to show you how to do it. I'm going to use a napkin. I'm going to use a napkin for another blanket. Why? Open it up one way.
Okay. I'm not sure how good a napkin's gonna take Mark for breathing.
That's okay. I don't really know.
Okay.
But okay.
Experiment.
So, it's an experiment. So basically, you design it however you want, but use the crease in the middle to guide you through it.
Should we have a full conversation in the background?
No. So what you do is you basically do a little design on your napkin, however you want. However, whatever. But use the crease to kind of guide you. Do one half of it and then do the other half. Which is nice. Just to kind of guide you through it. So I'm going to do a good and evil part of my blanket. So I'm going to do red for evil and blue for good. So I'm going to do the other side. Basically, you can do whatever kind of design you want, but I would recommend to color it in just so you know it's there and stuff. You don't have to color it in though. You don't have to. I am probably going to finish this later, but you can do whatever, just whatever. As you can see, what I am doing is a good and evil heart. A blanket. And then we need a background. I would recommend to color the entire thing. So I'm just doing blue dots on the blue side, and I'm going to do red dots on the red side. But I don't really know what to talk about while I'm doing this because it might take a while. That's okay. So as you can see, I did blue dots here, and then I'm going to do three red dots on the other side. I'm using like basically what I call an infrared. Infrared is kind of like a brighter red than a regular red. So I also have a brown card. I can do the good side or the evil side. You see if you just kind of use the crease. So it's not very stable. If I wanted to do this side, I can do that side. If I want to do this side, I can do this side. napkin is pretty good for the blanket. So you can just put that on there and then pull it off. That's how you make a cardboard box thing. So, like, subscribe.